Hi guys, can you hear me this time? I changed the input sound. Can you hear me this time? Ox na. Okay, thank you. So sorry for the bad sound kanina, but very good. So can you tell me, is this your first time to attend my webinar? So I can see some new names, so most likely some of you are new. Is your first time? Hindi naman. So for those of you are third time, first time, hi Dan, first time. Second time, hi Myla. Very nice to meet new people. Very good. Sino pa yung first time, second time, third time? Can you tell me how many times have you attended these webinars? So you didn't hear what I said earlier, so I'll just repeat it, okay? So what I said was, if you are interested, very good, you can't count, very good, X time. If you're interested to know the secrets of creating and preparing webinar videos, are you interested in that? How do I prepare my stuff para makagawa ako ng webinar? Because the output of a webinar is actually video. So today is video. And I don't even show my face, right? So if you're the kind of person who wants to learn how to do video, but shy ka, kita ang face mo, then are you interested to know how to prepare video for a webinar? Now, the usage of this information, you can use this for yourself, for your business, or you can use it for, you know, for somebody else's business. So, tinatanong ni X, kung shy ba ako? No, I'm actually not shy. The only difference why I don't use video in these recordings, in these webinars, is for the longest time, I've been hearing complaints that if I use video, the video is too slow compared to the voice. So, parang late yung bibig ko. So parang walang sense na magsalita ako kasi hindi naman sabay yung video ko at saka yung voice ko. Because of the internet speed in the Philippines. So that's why I don't use all video na gumagalaw. Because video, you always move. So it's not advisable kung mababagal ang internet speed ng mga na readers, viewers mo na mag-video talking head ka. Or action video. Now, can you tell me what is the speed of your internet? Because my internet is 10 Mbps. It's one of the fastest you can get kung hindi ka nakatira sa Ayala Alabang or sa Forbes Park or sa New Manila. So I'm running 10 Mbps, but my upload speed is less than 1 Mbps. And actually, all of us, no, hindi gumagamit ng fiber optic. Pag sinabi kong fiber optic, yan yung mga speeds na pwede mong bilhin sa Forbes Park, Ayala Alabang, New Manila, Ordoneta Village, Bel Air, you know, yung mga sila. And si Silio binasa Singapore, syempre mabilis ang internet ninyo. Pero ang hindi nyo alam, yung upload speed. Normally, kahit mabibilis ang internet download speed natin, ako 10, ikaw 15, si Junar 2, ang upload speed natin, kung nasa Pilipinas ka, 1 Mbps or less. Which makes it hard for me to send video out. Okay? So anyway, so that's trivia lang yan. Trivia na importante mo i-consider pag nag-video marketing ka, no? Somebody is gonna take the time to watch your video. You must have a fast loading video. Like, katulad niyan, nothing is moving in screen right now unless I move my mouse. So, hindi nahihirapan yung internet padala sa inyo yung image ng screen ko. Kasi nothing is moving. Pag naging tao yan, yan, mabilis yung movement and then it slows down the video. That's it. So I have a question for everyone. Why are you interested in video marketing in the first place? What are you going to use it for? Can you tell me in the questions box? Why are you interested in video marketing? Don't shy. Come on, don't shy. Tell me why you want to do this. There's a reason, right? So I'll wait for you. to answer. Magano lang ako, magpa-Facebook lang ako. I'll wait for you to answer. The No, hindi na wala ng sound. I'm waiting for you guys to answer. So, para may variety sa website, presenting info in a different way, sabi ni X. For my business and help my clients as well, sabi ni Rowena. To become an in-demand as a VA, sabi ni Janice. Dagdag skills in for business too, sabi ni Felros. More effective in relaying messages, sabi ni X. Want to learn techniques, sabi ni Chris, to learn new things. Well, I have a question. No? If you learn a new thing, how do you make sure that you won't forget it? So this is like a loaded question. Right? If you learn a new thing, you learn something new for me today, no? How do you ensure that you will not forget what you learned? Come on, loaded question. Ganyan. How do you ensure? Can be used for future business, business exposure, malaking tulong, additional knowledge, lalo na sa tamang pag-create ng video dito sa ginagawa kong online business. When you say it's for your business, can you explain what for? Masyadong generic yun. So, create value for my clients' marketing needs, very good. Gmail says, video is more effective in marketing products and services. Also true. Actually, very true yan. Video is very effective in marketing products. That's why you have commercials. Those are videos, right? Use frequently and, okay. So, very good. So, do you promise me that after tonight's event, you will do something? Is that? You will do something. You will practice what you have learned. Can you do that? Can you do that? I'm not really keen on FYI kind of learnings na, ay, nice to know yan. One day, magagamit ko rin yan. Eh, bakit? But one day? But hindi this week? Eh, wala akong product. Hindi naman kailangan ng product para mag-practice eh. Di ba? May product ka, ang pangalan, yourself. Di ba? Yourself. May birthday party ang anak mo. Produkto yon. Gumawa ka ng video to invite the people you wanna invite. Right? Bakit ka gagawa ng video? Eh, para mag-practice. Di ba? So, can you say, yes, magpa-practice ako. Sabi ni Myla, if you learn anything new, make sure you use it within 48 hours. Kasi makakalimutan mo yon if you don't use it agad. Tama. Diba? You have to use it agad. Practice nyo agad. Okay lang ba pangit ang ano? Pangit ang result ng ginawa ninyo? Okay lang ba yon? Hindi ka nais-nais? Pakisabi nga ang sagot. Eh, pangit yung ginawang video. Hindi maganda. Ano sa tingin mo? Okay lang ba yon? Pangit yung magandang results? Yung video mo? Okay lang yon. Tuloy mo lang. The important thing is, we don't really come here and teach you para mag-FYI ka. Oh, nice to know. Nice to know. Ganun-ganun. It's nice to know is something you forget after 2 days. Sabi nga ni Myla. So, what's the point? What's the point of being here if you're not going to act? Okay. And, pagkulang ang kaalaman, anong gagawin? Pagkulang, ano ba yung fun and crowd engagement? Ano ba yan? Sandali ah. Tanggalin ko. Pagkulang ang kaalaman, anong dapat gawin? Yan sa aking screen. Ano dapat gawin pag kulang ang kaalaman? Pakitanong, pakisabi. One is magtanong sa Google. Ano pa yung pangalawa? Ano pa yung isa? Pag hindi kaya ni Google, kasi minsan hindi alam ni Google. Huwag naman masyadong dependent kay Google. Minsan kasi walang alam si Google. Masyadong specialized yung alam, yung natanong mo, hindi alam ni Google. Maghanap ng mentor. Huwag lang basta a mentor. Dapat yung mentor na alam ang ginagawa. Diba? Diba? Yun yung sabi natin. We're here to learn. You ask experts. We're here to learn. We wanna know what the experts know to shortcut our knowledge. Right? To shortcut our knowledge. Our knowledge learning time. We wanna shortcut para marami tayong matutunan. Right? Okay, very good. So, I'm just establishing all of that because some of you don't really know me. I teach this stuff so that you guys can be more valuable in your work, in your pagiging virtual assistant, in pursuing online selling, in pursuing selling sa internet, even selling sa hindi sa internet. Yung video ipipresent nyo lang sa loob ng tindahan ninyo, at least may video kayo. Okay? So what I'm going to discuss today is the coverage is how I would do a video, step by step, and how I would prepare. When you create a video, you don't make a video basta-basta. You actually prepare for it. Can everybody type prepare? When you prepare, that's the bulk of the work. That's the bulk of the work. Okay? So when creating a video, it's not about creating a video. It's all about how to prepare for the video. Then we're also going to discuss the bonuses included in the Video Genesis program for those interested in asking the mentors of video making, sila Mike at saka sila Andy. Okay? Actually, ang totoo niyan, ang video expert, si Andy Jenkins. Partner lang niya si Mike. Okay? I don't know anong, marunong gumawa ng video si Mike, pero si Mike and Andy, sila yung gumawa ng Video Genesis program. Pero ang talagang expert talaga, siya yung producer, siya at executive producer ng mga Hollywood films. Pero hindi nyo alam yung mga films niya kasi hindi naman big eh. Mga small films lang. Hanapin nyo sa IMDb na doon si Andy Jenkins. So siya yung talaga yung video person dun sa pair na yan. So the Video Genesis program, we're gonna discuss the bonuses included and some Q&A if you have questions about it. Because I will be supporting this program for those who will be joining it. Kasi hindi naman ako ang expert talaga sa video. I do one kind of video and you're looking at it. Webinar is not a kind of video. The kind of video is called presentations. I also do screen capture. Pero essentially, it's live presentations. Okay, so this is it. So let's start na. 18 minutes na. So this, I'm going to show you my video marketing secrets. This is how I prepare my videos. Okay? So instead of also just telling you the slide, I'm going to actually show you how it's done. Okay? So in case you want to do your own video, this is how you would do it. I will not make this video available forever. I will make it public for a while hanggang siguro next week and then I'm gonna remove it from circulation. Okay lang ba yon? Kasi I don't wanna tell this secret to everyone, okay? Only for those who are ready. Question, are you ready? Say yes or no. Are you ready to learn this stuff? Because tonight I'm gonna ask you to do something. I'm gonna ask you to make a video. I'm gonna ask you to do a voiceover and you're going to record it and you're going to put it in YouTube. You're gonna show me. Last time I did that, only 3 people did something, which is very disappointing, no? Because the training is free. I want you to do something. Okay? Now, are you ready to do something? Okay? Do something. At least show me, no? Kung pakita sa mga kamag-anak mo, kasi renega ka lang nila, do something para meron kang retention sa matutupunan mo. Okay, first of all, first thing you need to do, you have to know, okay, that this is for webinar video only. Now, pwede mo siyang gawing recorded, hindi live. Pwede ka naman mag-explain na walang nakikinig, di ba? But the way I do it is I explain when somebody's listening. So it's live, so I get live questions. You don't have to do it my way, but you do have to prepare it my way. Let's start the preparation. Number one rule, the wordings are all personal. Remember, you're seeing slides, right? The slides that I'm preparing. The way you write the slides, okay, the words that you use, I'm rule number one. Okay, nandiyan ba si Manix? Wala ata, ano? Nakalimutan kong yayain. the way you write the slides, you use your own words. You use your own words. What if your client doesn't know anything much about marketing, meron siyang best-selling product lang, tapos bebenta mo yung produkto, tapos na ang ginawa mo, kinuha mo yung website niya, kinuha mo yung sinulat sa website niya, tapos nilagay mo dun sa video. That's a no-no. Do you know why? You are going to explain the product using your voice. For example, you cannot explain it if you're reading technical words. You have to use your own words. So rule number one, when you make a video, the wordings you use are personally selected by you. Kung sino magsasalita, dapat ganun siya magsalita. Okay, that's the first rule. Question, is that an easy rule, hard rule? Alam niyo na ba yan? Maybe if I tell you, sinabi ko sa inyo, syempre alam mo na yan kasi sinabi ko sa inyo. Then let's see, you create a video using your own words. Okay? And normally, you will create a video about something you don't even know anything about. So you have to still do research. Lalo na kung it's gonna be somebody for somebody else yung gagawa ka ng product. Okay? So there. That's one. Number two, so nakuha niyo yung first question, first secret ko. The wordings are personal. This is a big secret. I had to pay to find out this one. The second secret is every step is scripted. Every step in the video is scripted. Can you type scripted sa question box? Scripted. Meaning to say, hindi papasok dyan ng any idea, any quotation, any side comment na hindi na-prepare in advance. Okay. Jomar, mahilig ka sa side comment. Huwag niyo akong gagayahin. Sanay ako mag-side comment. For most people, you must script everything. Okay? Script everything. So nothing is forgotten. Does it mean you will rehearse? For most people, yes. You will rehearse. You will rehearse by reading the slides without any recording. Pero i-record mo, normally, ganito ang secret ha, isa pang secret sa scripted. Whenever you rehearse video na voiceover, tas merong mga text, katulad ng nakikita mo ngayon, record all rehearsals. Usually, the first rehearsal is the best. Number two, pag nag-scripted ka na video, you do not do take two. Gets mo? Dere-derecho ang video mo. Hindi ka magta-take two. Kung gusto mag-take two ka from the beginning. Okay, that's a secret. Do you know that is a secret? Some people, ang ginagawa nila, puputuli nila, ay, cut, nasi-CR ako, tapos na-try niyang pumasok ulit. Pag pumasok ka ulit, tapos nagaling kang CR, iba na yung intonation mo, iba na yung pacing mo, iba na yung energy mo. Kasi, as a video, no, a video is like a movie. Can you type movie? A movie has starts small, grows, goes reaches a climax, when naglalaban na yung bida at saka kontrabida, then goes down. Diba? Tapos na siya. So, pag sumira ka sa gitna ng movie, what happens to you? You miss scenes, right? When you miss scenes, in this case, ikaw nagsasalita, the energy changes. The pacing changes, the intonation changes, the volume changes, everything changes. So you're starting off from the beginning again because you forgot the energy level wherein you stopped the video. So whenever you do a video, make it short. By the way, when you're doing videos na hindi webinar, your videos is gonna be 1 minute to 3 minutes lang. Can you type that? 1 minute to 3 minutes lang. Especially when you're selling products. 1 minute, 3 minutes, 50 seconds, yan lang. Ganyan kaiksi lang ang video mo. Hindi kayang tiyagain ng mga tao ang mahahabang video unless it's a lecture. Katulad ngayon, this is a lecture. So, kaya niyong tiisin niyang, hindi pala tiisin, kaya niyong i-consume yung 1 hour 90 minutes kasi it's a lecture. For most marketing videos which are not lectures, okay, or show and tells, 1 to 3 minutes lang yan. Lalo na kung product show and tell yan, papakita ko sa iyo paano gamitin itong snowmobile, 1 to 3 minutes lang yan. Unless you're going to teach me the advanced features of using the snowmobile. Advanced features of using this keyboard na high-tech. Yan, pwedeng mahaba-haba. Okay, pero hindi na siya gantong klaseng slides. Ano na siya? Ano, live video na siya. Okay? So, ganyan lang kay-click. So, kung akala mo malaking trabaho ang video, actually, hindi. Most people do not have the patience to listen to more than 3 minutes of video. sometimes 1 minute video hindi nila kaya. So most of your intro videos will be 1 minute or less, up to 3 minutes. Okay. So biglang, hi, ang ikse. Oh, mag-voice over ka for 3 minutes. That's why, if you script it, okay lang, ulitin mo pa ulit-ulit. Kasi nga, 3 minutes na max out ka naman. Diba? Okay lang. So, hindi ka maiiyak na, paulitin ko na naman. Ganun. Okay. So, by the way, the more you do this, the more used to it you become. So, madali lang. Tumadali lang. Okay, next one is, third secret is, start with a list of things to discuss. So, yan yung start. So, let me just do that now. So, we are going to start typing something. So, anong gusto niyong topic? Gagawa ko ng topic. I'm gonna do this live. Okay? So, this is how I start. I'm literally showing you how I start. I need to discuss something. Let's say on Monday. On Monday, the topic is content marketing. Okay. So, sulat ko muna yung topic name. Okay? And that's the topic, content marketing. That's Monday. Hindi, wag na lang yan. Tuturo ko na lang OMC2. Ayan, OMC3, which is Online Mentoring Club 3. This is my new club. So this is how I would make the presentation for OMC3, which I have not created. So you'll be able to see it. Gagawa. The ideas I want to present, for example, would be OMC2 versus OMC3. OMC3 has WordPress. Did you notice how I do this? One idea per line. See that? I'm just gonna start with a list of things to discuss. Yeah? So this is things I wanna discuss. OMC3 has live meetings every 3 months. So pinakita ko yung difference ng Online Mentoring Club 3 and 2. Hosted WordPress. OMC3 has free hosting for WordPress. Ayan. Tapos, OMC3 has will make a ano yan? VA will create a WordPress for you. Let's say yan lang yung gusto kong sabihin. Kasi, mabilis. So, that's what I want to discuss for OMC3. My new mentoring program. This is also the grand prize for the contest I have in Facebook, by the way. So, the mentoring program runs for 12 months. So, ito lang is, by the way, I'm telling you how I'm doing this. It's 12 months program, most likely. 12 months program. You can pay 12 months. You can pay monthly. You can pay full with discount. Did you notice it's one line per idea and very, very short? Very short. Short na yan. One line per idea and very, very short. Gets? Now, let me move to the next one. I have the list of things to discuss. Then I have to include intro question. Include the introductory question. Do I want to ask you a question from the beginning? I am going to whisper now. Because this is a very important secret. Are you ready to hear the whisper? Say yes. There's an introductory question. And there's a reason why there is an intro question. You have to prepare the intro question. I'm going to whisper to you what the intro question should be. Are you ready to listen to the intro question? Sa mga naghuhugas ng pinggan dyan, tapos nalayo kayo sa speaker, hindi nyo ito masyado maririnig. So I suggest, lumapit kayo. Ito yon. Ilalagay ko sa top yung intro question. And the intro question would be a question like this. Are you ready to level up and earn more online? Itong tanong na to is answerable by only one answer. What is the answer? And are you ready to level up and earn more online? There is only one answer to this kind of question. And whenever you make an intro question, it should only be answerable by only one answer. So pag gumawa kayo ng video, magtatanong kayo sa simula pa lang ng tanong na only answerable by one, by what? One answer. And throughout your video, magtatanong kayo ng tanong na only answerable by? Only answerable by? Okay. Nag-guess nyo na yun, ha? So, di ko na explain. Hanggang dun na lang yun. Now, I told you, this is a secret. I paid to find out the secret. So, for those of you who want to understand, bakit? Ah, pag-aaralan nyo yan. Gusto nyo malang, eh, bakit kailangan gawin yun? Eh, kaya, sinabi ko nga sa inyo, binayaran ko pa yun para malaman ko yung sikreto na yun. So, kung ako sa'yo, sundin mo na lang. Kasi, pag-aaralan mo pa ang neuro-linguistic programming para maintindihan mo bakit kailangan ko pang gawin yun. So, anong pag-aaralan? Anong pag-aaralan? Neuro-linguistic programming. Gusto nyo pag-aaralan? Hindi. So, gawin nyo na lang. Thank you. Next secret. Include last things you're going to say. Because normally, nakakalimutan yan. What are the last things you're going to say? At the end of my short presentation, I would want to tell them to go visit a website, which I don't know yet. So I would have to say visit. Lagay ko dito. Visit. Maybe OMC2, OMC3. I mean, yeah, I don't know. I don't know if that website exists. Invento lang po. So, visit OMC3. That's it. jhilari.com/OMC3. Plus, I'm not finished. Kasi you want to remind people of stuff. So you'll have to write down everything you need to say at the end. Would be, deadline is blank to get this bonus. This, let's say, 24,000 peso bonus. So this is stuff I need to say at the end. I need to say that. Plus, if you're going to do a regular video, you might as well say, see you next Monday, 8 p.m., and you'll learn, enter. Nag-enter ako kasi one liner per ano, slide eh. One line per slide. Okay? Ito pala ito. Join, ito yung actual site. Join OMC3. Yan. You'll learn how to raise your, ask for a raise. This, next Monday ito. Totoo nga pala to. Part 2. Okay. Plus interview with an American. Sa Monday yan, next week. May tayong interview with an American. We're gonna interview an actual American! Okay. So, it reminds them to go back to your webinar next week. At the same time, kung wala kang webinar next week, you can just tell them, subscribe to my videos in YouTube. So, lahat ng kailangan mong tandaan at the end, kailangan sabihin, isulat mo dyan para hindi mo nakakalimutan, hindi ka nagmamadali. Tapos, ay, nakalimutan ko! Tapos na yung video. So, write down everything you need to say there. Tapos, itong question ko sa taas, pwede ko itong ilagay sa gitna ng aking discussion. Because it's answerable by, what answer should be given when I ask, are you ready to level up and earn more online? It's only answerable by one answer. Okay. So, mga ayos sumagot, pahala kayo. Inuulit ko na lang para sa inyo. So, nalagay ko na yung ending and let me proceed to the next one. Include website you want people to visit. Very important. Include the website. Sinabi ko na yon. The website you want to visit here is jlar.com/joinlmc3. Yan yung gusto kong makapuntahan nila. Now, next secret is as much as possible, avoid live site use. Eto. Pag bubukas ka ng website sa internet, tapos live siya, or magre-record ka, huwag mo siyang gawin habang nagre-record ka. Diba? Gusto mong pumunta sa Facebook, ganon. Paano kung bigla na lang tumigil si Facebook, hindi umandar? So, don't open a website live. Or while doing, you know, magre-record ka, you're gonna try to open Facebook now. So, hinihintay ka ng tao eh, pinipindot mo si Facebook. Huwag mong gagawin yun. Ano, ang tagal mag-load. Tapos, nakalimutan mo pasok yung password mo, tapos mag-enter ka, and you're recording everything. Don't do that. What you need to do is prepare this page immediately. Screenshotin mo yan. Tapos ilagay mo siya sa slide mo. Try not to open live websites when you're doing recording. Because it's too slow, your video will be too slow. Tapos you'll have to edit that slowness out, which is no fun. Sinasabi ko sa inyo, when you're gonna edit yung slow parts ng web ng ano mo, ng webinar mo o ng video mo, hindi masayang mag-edit ng slow parts. Hahanapin mo lahat ng slow parts. Because wala namang value when people see you open Safari, people type facebook.com, they wait for you to enter email password, di ba? Wala. So, don't do that. Do not do live site usage unless sure na sure ka mabilis ang internet mo and wala ka naman choice. What you need to do is copy the screen, ilagay mo sa presentation po. Okay? Now, next. Are you still there, everyone? Mabilis ba? Pakisabi po, are you still there? Mabilis ba? Okay. So, next is type in your text. Ah, ito na yung rule na ginagawa ko ever since I've started. One line, one slide. When you type in your text, it's one line, one slide. Game? So, tell me if you're using Mac or Windows. Type nyo lang Mac or Windows. Mac or Windows. Kasi ibang instruction for Mac or Windows. So, if you're going to give this to a virtual assistant, to somebody else working for you, you have to include image ideas sa listahan mo. So, kung halimbawa, gusto mo maglagay dito ng ano, ng VS image, lagay mo dyan, VS image, para lagyan niya ng image. Halimbawa, lagay mo dito ng WordPress image. Okay? Tapos, 3 image. Ganon. Bigyan mo siya ng idea kung anong lagay niyang image. Okay? PC desktop image. Kung bibigay mo sa ibang tao tong presentation mo. Okay? Now, let us move on. So, lagay mo na yung ideas mo for images. If you already know, ikaw naman gagawa ng presentation mo, di huwag mo na ilagay yung idea. Now, may nagtatanong anong font ang ginagamit ko. You have to decide what font you want. I normally encourage people to use sans serif font. Ano ba yung sans serif font? Yun yung font na hindi maarte. Ang maarte, yung Times Roman. Alam yung Times New Roman, di ba? Times New Roman. Ayan, no? Mukha siyang pang newspaper. So, ang hindi maganda yan eh, tingnan sa internet. Maganda yan tingnan sa dyaryo. Sa internet, ang maganda yan, katulad yan, Helvetica, maganda yan. Ang font ko is Has Grotesque, which Tahoma's okay also. So let's look for Tahoma. Tahoma's also okay. Ay, sans serif ang Tahoma eh. No. Hindi. That's, Tahoma is sans serif. Verdana is good. And Tahoma is no. Ang sans serif, yung letter I, tinan nyo, mukha siyang, meron siyang parang Roman column. Ang I ng grotesque is just a single line. Okay? So, I try to not use a serif font. I use a sans serif font. Yung pinakamadali dyan, mag-Helvetica to be safe. Just use Helvetica, just to be safe. Okay, but ako ang ginagamit ko is Alt-Has Grotesque na font. Okay, that's for me because it's for my personality and yun ang gustong font ni Nikki. Actually, yun ang pinakatotoong dahilan dyan. Okay, let's move on. By the way, ito na. Meron ka ng text. If you paste mo siya ngayon to Word, and then when you pasted it in Word, it looks exactly like this. Yeah? Ganto dapat ang itsura niya sa Word. Tapos sa loob ng Microsoft Word, may tinatawag na export to PowerPoint. I'm gonna look for that for you. Word export to PowerPoint. Hindi to ginagamit na maraming tao. Ito, sabi ko sa inyo, sikreto to eh. Ito yung actually ginagamit ko madalas noong unang panahon na ang mga VAs ko ay naka-ano. Hindi pa sila naka-Mac. So, save as, nasaan na ba yun? Hindi yan. Sa Microsoft Word, you can export it to PowerPoint. Ito ata. Send to PowerPoint. Sorry. Ayan. File, send to Microsoft Word. Mali. Hindi yan. File, send to PowerPoint. Anybody here have PowerPoint? Pakita niyo, sabi mo sa akin kung ano yung ano. Paano siya ginagawa. Meron niyang option eh. Send to, tama, send to PowerPoint. Nalala ko na. So, I'm just gonna fix my slide. It's not export. It's send to. Okay? So, instead of doing this in PowerPoint, you do this in Word. Tapos, one slide, one line, and then send to PowerPoint. Okay? You don't even have to save the document. So, pag na-send mo na sa PowerPoint, mukha na siyang nasa PowerPoint. Okay? Pag nag-send to PowerPoint siya, by the way, I don't have PowerPoint, so I use Mac. So this is Keynote, which is kalaban ng PowerPoint. So it looks exactly like this. Na. Pag nag-send to PowerPoint ka, buksan mo si PowerPoint, mukha na siyang ganito, pero wala siyang decorations. Ay, wala siyang formatting, wala siyang color sa likod. That's okay. At least nalagay mo na yung bawat slide, one line per slide. There. Isang slide ito. Now, that's for Windows users. For Macintosh users, naka-keynote ka, pay attention, I'm actually gonna do it. And the answer there is, I'm gonna open a new keynote para tong new PowerPoint, essentially. Okay? Tapos, pay attention, Mac users na gumagamit ng keynote. View, outline. View, outline. And then, click here sa left side sa outline. And then, I'm going to go to my Word file, copy. Doesn't have to be Word. Could be any text editor. Copy that. Go to the outline. Right click. Paste. Done. So, now, I have the slides one at a time in my keynote. Ganito mangyayari sa PowerPoint, by the way. Pero hindi siya designed. Tignan mo. Lahat sila puti yung background, ganun. Pero nandiyan na lahat ng text. I didn't have to do anything. So, what I need to do now, according to my slides, sandali ha. Sorry. Is, sandali. Kailangan, alam nyo kung paano gamitin ang master slides. Alam nyo slide master? Anybody here? You don't have to use the slide masters? So, both PowerPoint and Keynote, kailangan paglaruan yung slide master para mag-adjust lahat ng slides. So, in my case, I'm going to adjust the slides on the newly created presentation. Okay? Gagawin ko, highlight ko silang lahat. Pipili ako ng theme na gusto ko. Maybe ganito, typeset. Tapos, i-apply ko siya dun sa yan. Bawa, ito yung gusto ko. Tapos paglalaroan ko yung tahan ko yung navigator, paglalaroan ko yung master. Sa PowerPoint, iba yung location ng master. Dito sa keynote dyan, pipindutin ko yung nasa taas. Paglalaroan ko to. Yung text nito. Which is, I'm gonna make it into my favorite font. And I'm gonna make it 110. Make it bigger a bit. Now, wait. Mali. Don't design yet. Wait. Go back to my outline. Dito pa lang, paglalaroan ko na yung font. Gagawin ko na siyang Outhouse Grotesque. Gagawin ko na siyang 110 fonts. Kita mo? Mabilis lang. In-highlight ko tong text sa left. Paglalaroan ko na agad yung font dito pa lang. 190. You see that? Do you get it? Essentially, pinaglaroan ko yung master slide. Later ko pa paglalaroan. Ngayon, paglalaroan ko lang yung text muna. And then, saka ko siya paglalaroan ng master slide. Now, if you don't know anything about master slides, then you have to learn what it is. Again, if you don't know how, there is Google. If Google doesn't work, you go ask mentors. Okay? So, I can now modify this para yung master niya ito. So, I'm just bring that lower there, which I love to do, para mag-adjust silang lahat. And I change the font again. just to be consistent and make it bigger. Yan, and that's it. Oh, linis na siya. Ano na lang. Kung gusto kong palitan yan, palitan ko si Master. Palitan ko yung background ni Master and stuff like that. And so, of course, changing this PowerPoint is not the topic. The point is, I'm now able to make a simple PowerPoint that I can use for video. By the way, you're looking at a very simple white background and text with a text na PowerPoint, right? Kahit na parang hindi pa siya tapos, the last secret is, this is the format that most marketers use today. White background, black text, big words, very, very short, very, very short words in a slide. That's what they use to sell, most of them. Tingnan mo mabuti. Okay. The only difference is, naka-center yung text nila. Akin hindi. Okay? So you have to center your text somehow. Okay? I don't know how to center the text ngayon eh. Pero that's generally the case. And now, saan na tayo? So I'm gonna go back to the slides. And that is how you make the presentation. Okay? Tapos, kung meron kang gustong paalala sa sarili mo, modify the slides directly para ma-remind mo yung sarili mo na, oh, you have to pause here. You have to put some reminders in the slides for yourself. So wala kang extra na notes na i-take. Every reminder you need to do should be on the slide. Okay? And then, when you're ready for to use the presentation, just go ahead and start presenting. Katulad nung kanina, present mo na siya. Man, naayos mo na to. Assume na natin naayos mo na to, ah. So, press play, and then you start talking. Now, to record this, you need some software. And software you can use for short-term recording, tinuturo din nila to sa loob ng Video Genesis, is Jing. Less than 5 minutes, Jing. Jing will record your screen and your voice at the same time. That's just good. Do it. Just do it. So, yung Jing, hindi pala siya jing.com, ah. I-Google mo si Jing. Google mo siya. It's a screen recorder that listens to your voice also. Okay? So, that's the very quick one. Now, yung mga Windows users, your Jing. Now, if you are a Macintosh user, it's very easy. Just go look for your QuickTime. And QuickTime has, it's built into all Macs, by the way. You go to QuickTime Player, tapos meron siyang new screen recording. Just click that. Tapos, pag kinlik mo siya, it's gonna ask, saan galing yung sound? Lagayin mo internal microphone. Tapos pindutin mo yung record. And then you talk. Okay, halimbawa, ayan. Okay, are you ready to level up and learn online? Next. And introducing blah, 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 blah. Tapos when you're finished with the recording, click stop. And I actually just did recording just now, so you can listen to it right now.
Tapos when you finish with the recording, click stop. Tapos when you finish with the recording, click stop.
Yan, see, nag-record siya. Mali-mali yung timing ko. Anyway, I didn't want to do that na live. I just want to show you how it works. It's very easy to run QuickTime. And again, QuickTime, new screen recording. If you're a Macintosh user. Okay, ganun kadali. Tapos, sa QuickTime, meron kang export to internet. So, wag na kayong pakahirap, no? Pag yan, export to web. So, sabihin naman niya kung anong format. Export to iTunes, export to web. And i-format mo siya for web, bring it up to YouTube, done. You have a video. Okay? It's very easy, as long as you have the courage to do it. Okay? Kung mali, di mali. Ulit. Kaya nga ginagawa yung video, hindi nyo ginagawa ng live, right? So let me put this away and go back to this one. Now, whenever you do all your slides, just check for readability. Sobrang problema yun na maraming tao na takot gumamit ng big text. Every speaker I know, except for a very few, they don't understand that people can't read stuff because they think everybody has a big computer. Pero not true. You have a slide, they're reading it in their iPhone, or much worse, in their very, very small Nokia screens. They can't read your slides. they can hear your words, but they can't read your slides. Or they have an iPad. Okay? And they have a very, very small computer. So, design your slides para mabasa din sa maliliit na screens na yan. Okay? So, as big as you can use the font, like mine, hindi ako nahihiyang gumamit ng malalaking font. These are big fonts, right? These fonts, I don't really put much left and right allowance. Can you read it? Walang minimum font size, walang maximum font size. Punuin mo si screen. Punuin mo si screen. Kasi sometimes, maglalagay ka ng picture dyan, may words. Siyempre, liliit yung words mo. Kasi may picture. So, it's not about the number of font. Use your eyes. Yeah? Yung mata mo. Sabi ba ng mata mo, malaki na yan. Malalaman mo naman pag nagtitipid ka kung ano eh. Well, actually, wala ka naman binabayad. Nagtitipid ka pa eh. Labo, no? Malalaman mo kung nagtitipid ka kung sinasabi mong malaki na to. I mean, hello? Can you read it? It's 18 points. I just changed the fonts. 72. Ang laki-laki ng screen, tinitipid mo. Wala namang natanggal na pera sa'yo. 11 points. I mean, hello? Come on. Di ba? Hindi kasi masasabing minimum maximum. Kasi ilan ba yung words mo? Marami kang words eh. As much as you can, pagkasyahin mo silang lahat na wala masyadong space para mabasa siya kahit maliit yung screen. Okidoki? Klaro ba? Humihingi kayo ng number sa akin, eh, paano kung hindi kasya yung letters mo? Di wala akong magagawa. Hindi pwede yung number ko. 170 points. Ano? Tapos sabi ni Jammer 170. Eh, hindi naman kasya. Diba? Kasi marami kang sinabi. Which brings me to the point. Bawal magsabi ng marami sa video. Konti lang muna. Para next slide ka na agad. Ayan. So, that winds up my secret discussion on the secrets of webinar videos. I think that's one kind of webinar. Next topic is video genesis inclusions. For those of you who are willing to learn more about i-master niyo yung level ng videos, just consider yung video genesis inclusions. Now, why am I supporting video genesis? Simply because hindi naman ako ng expert on video making. Mas magaling pa si Bo sa akin kasi marami siyang kinds of videos. I hardly do live videos. I only do voiceover videos most of the time since 2008. So, these guys, I know, they're offering this at the same rate as Authority ROI. 97,000, ano? Hindi. About $100 for 3 months lang. Around $300 lang eh. So, here are the inclusions for those interested. It's around, ano pala? $247 lang pala. Lahat-lahat pag nagbayad ka in advance. So, 247 times what? 42. So, it's like 10,300 lang yung investment mo dito sa plan nila. Now, somebody's asking me, you know, by the way, if you have questions, go ahead and ask me na. Okay? Somebody already asked me kung... Ay, nakalimutan ko yung tanong. kung may bibiling ka pa ba after this? Yeah, totoo. Meron kang bibilihin. Obvious. Did you notice? They're gonna ask you to buy a camera, a microphone, and a headset. Obvious. Question. Why are you going to buy a camera, a headset, and a microphone? You can't do video if your computer doesn't have a microphone. Okay? Sorry. And if you're going to use a camera, sinasuggest nila gumamit ka ng smartphone. Hopefully, it's an iPad, iPhone, or a Galaxy na ma-high-end yung camera. Okay? And the USB headset, of course, is pwede naman earphones, pero normally, you need to use high-quality headsets para marinig mo yung bad noise pag ikaw ay gumawa ng video. I use a high-end brand of headsets. I have it right now. Pangalawa ko na to kasi nabulok yung una, nadurog yung kable. I need it para mairinig ko lahat ng kind of sounds dun sa recordings kasi pag nilagay nyo sa earphones nyo yan tapos naka-iPad kayo, masakit pakinggan. So, I need to hear all of those. Okay? Sabi ni X, nag-join na daw siya. Thank you. Yung upsell nila is a live event. Sino dito na sa Amerika? Taas ang kamay! Ba't kayo pupunta doon? if I were you, I would go. Pero wala naman ako sa America. Wala pa akong US visa. Na-deny ako eh. Thank you. Congratulations. So, hindi ako makapunta. Kahit gusto kong pumunta, hindi ako makapunta. So, they're gonna upsell you to a live event. That's one of the upsells I know. They're gonna upsell. That's it. Actually, yun na. They're gonna downsell you to something else. I don't know what that is. A downsell is something na mababa yung price. I don't remember. I've seen the name of it. I don't know what it is. So this is a course that will teach you for about 10,000 bucks, which is really cheap. Kasi my OMC3 program is 22,000 bucks. That's mine. Okay. These guys are offering their expertise for 10,000 or 97,000 times 3. So ilan kani yan? Times 3 kasi this monthly is 4,000 bucks for 3 months lang. So it's a bargain considering talagang $2,000 naman lagi yung mga prices ng mga nila. So ang pinaka lowest rate ng mentoring ko is 22,000. Okay? So there yung in-offer talaga sobrang baba. Now, if I were you and you wanna learn video, learn it from experts mo na mas credible kesa sa akin. Okay? I'm credible. I know how to do video, but these guys know how to do multiple kinds of videos. So, if you're gonna follow my footsteps, you will have to invest in your own training, which I did that many times, and I still do it. I still invest in my own training. I'm also joining Video Genesis, if you don't know. So, ganun. So, I'm endorsing this to you because these guys know their stuff. They showed us yung kaya nilang gawin, iba-ibang klase, and they're gonna go through different kinds. I taught you about webinar videos. Sila discuss nila doodle, animation, presentation. I taught you about presentation, software demo, ginagawa ko yan. Fly on the wall, I don't do that. Interview, I don't do that. Hangouts, we do that. Hippie style, we don't do that. Direct to camera, I don't do that. Story style, I don't do that. Whiteboard, I don't do that. Talking head, I don't do that. So may mga video styles na hindi ko pa tinuturo sa inyo because I don't do it. I can, but I don't have the lecture nor the experience to actually tell you na I'm credible to do that. So I'm endorsing these guys too. Again, the guarantee is all there. You can ask for a refund anytime you want. And I have a support system for that. For the next 3 months, starting August, we're going to have 2 webinars a month. And this is going to be hosted by me for 3 months. So 6 webinars, all of them recorded. And if we get 20 people to join the Video Genesis, we are going to do a live meeting every month. So ang deadline nito is about the 23rd of that's next week, 23rd of July. The deadline to join para makuha niyo yung bonuses. Kasi hindi naman magko-close yung kanilang joining eh. Pero magko-close yung bonuses. Eh, let me tell you the secret itong mga ito. Hi Lovie, thanks for joining. Ang secret nila talaga ganito. One of the best things you can get from these programs ng mga foreigners are the bonuses. Sinasabi ko sa inyo, yung mga bonuses nila, mas maganda pa kasi sa pinabenta nila. That's how they do it. Okay, that's how they structure their products. No, the first bonus is a traffic module. You have a video, how do you bring people to the video? Actually, that's one of the most important things. And they made it into a bonus. So, they did that, siyempre, para mag-join tayo before the end of the deadline, the launch deadline, which is the 23rd of July. So, okay lang naman yun because it helps us get traffic to our video. The second bonus is video modules from Video Boss. Now, Video Boss is the first product na ginawa nila noon pa for video learning. So, meron siyang green screen production, animation effects, music production. So, very important also. Unless you don't use music. I don't use music. So, tapos yung third bonus nila is to behind the scenes, paano nila ginawa yung helicopter style na, yung parang may helicopter pero wala namang helicopter. Alam nyo bang walang helicopter yon? Oh, yeah. The helicopter style na video, tuturo nila paano nila ginawa yung 5 videos na ginamit nila sa launch nila. It's very good kasi minsan ka lang mag behind the scenes sa isang, video. And yeah, there's the multicast marketing machines na hindi na nakita mo na ba yung multicast, Lyovi? Nag-join ka na eh. multicast marketing machines is actually a bonus inside the Video Genesis. Hindi ata nila sinama sa bonus nila, parang naging surprise. So it's kind of an unannounced bonus. Multicast marketing machines teaches you how to put the video you create into iTunes para maging siyang podcast. Actually, marunong ako nun. Marunong akong gumawa ng ganun. I just don't do it, but I know how to put your video into a podcast. Okay, so yun yung laman ng multicast marketing machines. Para people using iPhones and iPads, makukuha nila yung video mo na mabilis. Kaya kasi multicasting yun. Okay, so that's one way. That's one of their bonuses, the multicast marketing machines. So, Yovie, is multicast marketing machines inside Video Genesis? Is it inside? Anyway, so let's wait for her answer. Oh, nakita niyo na, oh. Iwalay siya, pero you are given access to the multicast marketing machines, which is good. You cannot use multicast marketing machines kung wala ka pang video. So for those of you seriously considering a different kind of skill sets, which is video creation, kukonti lang ang inyong kalaban dito. And for those of you who were serious about learning this stuff, let me give you a short secret na magagalit sa akin si Jasmine. Oh, meron kaming kilala na gusto nang mag-hire ng video editors. Editor pa lang ha, hindi creator, editor. Alam niyo ba kung magkano ang bayad sa isang video editor? Taga-edit lang, hindi pa creator. Ikaw, creator ka na pag nag-aral ka nito. Alam mo kung magkano bayad? 35,000 pesos. So, unahan na lang sa inyo sinong titinag para pag-aralan ito. Tapos, after 1 month, bawi na ba ang bayad mo? Tanongin kita. Bawi na ba ang bayad mo sa training na to na hindi naman akin? Pag nakuha mo yung job na yon, alam mo ba paano mo makukuha yung job na yon? Submit your videos to us. Ite-testing ka naman ng tao. We won't tell you who it is. Ite-testing ka ng tao, pero sikat siya. Mas sikat siya kaysa sa akin. Tapos, pag nagustuhan niya yung editing mo, tapos! Done! Meron kang monthly, 35K. Video editor ka, foreigner ang client mo. Mabait pa. Kilala ko yung client mo. Mabait siya. Bawing-bawi. Pati yung gastos mo sa gadgets. Remember, when you do video editing, hindi ka magagasto sa gadgets mo kung meron kang kliyente. But to get in touch with this guy, you need to get in touch with us kasi kami yung makausap sa kanya. Okay? Ay, gagalit na sa akin si Jasmine. Kasi Jasmine ang kumausap eh. So that's average yan, average. Okay? Sabi ni Christel, happy na daw siya sa 30K. Hindi daw 35. Thank you, akin na lang yung 5. Okay? Sa'yo na lang yung 30. Happy na rin ako. Okay? So, I'm not kidding. There's really somebody out there looking for video editors and they pay dearly for video editors. The only thing you need to do is be professional. Pag sinabi kong be professional, hindi ibig sabihin nun, magaling ka mag-video. Ang ibig sabihin nun, pag hindi mo naiintindihan yung instruction niya, sasabihin mo sa kanya na hindi mo naiintindihan. Yun lang ang hinihingi niya sa'yo. Kasi kilala ko yung mga problema ng mga foreigners. Eh. The problem with Filipinos working, the very skilled, working for foreigners, is that they're very scared to tell their clients na nahihirapan na sila. The only requirement we have, if you know any video at all, is mag-apply ka sa kanya, pero professional ka dapat. And I think kailangan full-time ka. Not sure. Okay. Pwede mo mag-apply as video editor kahit hindi bibili ng Video Genesis. Pwede naman as long as you can prove it. Okay? Sabi ni Christel, if you're inside Video Genesis, once you purchase it, it's yours forever and ever. Of course. Of course. But remember this kind of stuff. They change. Technology changes. And websites change. Services change. Ayan. Okay? Ba't ka natatakot sa thunderstorm? Dito nga may thunderstorm eh, pero malayo. Okay lang yung thunderstorm. When was the last time may kakilala ka na nasunog yung bahay dahil sa thunderstorm? Okay, wala. Okay, fine. So, Yun. So yan yung laman ng video genesis. So I do encourage you, kung naghahanap ka ng level up, this is one specific thing that you can learn na madali lang gawin. So as long as alam mo yung mga tools, may tiyaga kang aralin, this is not done for you. This is skills. Once you have this, hindi mo mawala sa'yo. Okay? So ano pa? I'm gonna cover sa mga webinars ko, yung mga stuff na hindi nila i-cover. I'm sure they're not gonna cover yung mga very specific editing techniques na ginagawa ko. So mayroon kami mga ginagawang editing techniques. Like, ito, hindi masisira yung computer mo. Normally, do you remember sa webinar ko, I do this? Alam mo yan? Nagka-clap ako. I'll explain to you why I do that. Ngayon, hindi na ako nagka-clap eh, pero dati nagka-clap ako. So there's a reason why I do that. And those are the certain small things na kailangan nyo maintindihan. And I'll guide you in the webinars kung meron kayo hindi naintindihan sa kanya. Yun naman ang support ko sa inyo eh. To support you so you'll learn how to do this stuff. So let's go to your assignment para nalaman natin kung meron kayong natutunan sa aking short webinar. You're going to make a webinar. Oh no, you're gonna make a video, hindi webinar, about my new program called OMC3. Wala kayong alam tungkol sa kanya. Ito na. Wala kayong alam, di ba? Ito na yung text. Ito na yung text ng video. Gagawin nyo siyang video. Magvo-voiceover ka. But you're going to modify the text para it's you talking. Yep. Yeah, you're going to talk. You're going to use your personality. You're going to use your own words. And you're going to explain people what OMC3 is. And that's your assignment. It's very short. You can edit it, remove some stuff. But essentially, you're going to keep it less than 1 minute, 1 minute, 3 minutes, and explain what OMC3 is. And that's your assignment. Especially those na hindi naman bibili ng video genesis, wala kang excuse to create a video, right? Now you do. I'm going to give a prize to those who submit. Hindi kailangan magaling, kailangan mag-submit. So you're gonna get a prize if you submit, and you get a nice prize if you give me a good result. Okay ba? So I'm gonna send you the text, obviously. I will send you the text. So you can create a video. Pagandahan ng video, meaning use your personality, use your, kung wala kang creativity, use your interest. Kasi everybody's interested in something. Your deadline is 7 days. Next week, 7 days. That's your deadline. Actually, you have less than 7 days. Sa Monday na ang deadline mo. Monday. Pwede ako maging generous. Pwede natin exceed. Pero, just do it, man. I'm gonna give a bonus for those who, I think you love the bonus. I won't tell you what the bonus is. But it's gonna recognize your skill, which is something that is priceless. Okay, I'm gonna give you a bonus if you make a video. I'm gonna give you a gift if you win. Meaning, sa lahat ng videos na submit, ikaw yung pinaka gusto ko. Remember, you need to use your personality. Okay, you're not gonna use my text. That's my text. That's my words. Use your own words. Pero ganito rin. Ganito rin yung format. Okay? Sample lang. I'm gonna edit this and I will I'm gonna send you the text tonight na rin. And yun natin. There are 46 people here. Kanina 47. And let's see you do something about it. Let's see you do the video, right? And if you are looking for expertise, sino dito ang ano? Walang joke. Sino dito ang seryoso matutunan ng video? And considering getting the video genesis program. Sino dito yun? May tatlo nang sumali. So, kulang na lang tayo ng 17 para mag-live meeting tayo. Yay! Lalagay ko sa email yung assignment. I-email ko sa inyo yung assignment. Meron naman akong emails na lahat ng mag-join. Okay? Yan. Kung plan niyo bumili na kayo ng video genesis. They are still adding bonuses. Don't wait for the bonuses to stock up. You're gonna get it anyway. Okay? Smile na si Rowena na yung video genesis is 4,000 a month for 3 months. So it's around 10,000 pesos. Kasi may discount ka pag nag-full payment ka. 10,000 pesos for... Sorry, I can't remember the actual price. It's in dollars. Sandali, ito. So the payment is 247 times 42... It's 10,374 for pag ano ka, pag nag-full payment ka. So, where do I type that? Sandali ah. Okay. I'm gonna type this in para clear. So, kung nag-full payment ka, it's only 10,374, which is really too low for a 3-month program. 3-month program lang to ah. Pag foreigner ang kausap mo, laging 3-month program. Hindi nila papalitan yan. Gusto talaga nilang 3 months eh. Okay? So, that is their full payment rate. And for those of you na magma-monthly, 3 months lang, is around 4,000. 42 ang dollar, no? So, this is the full payment. And 4,000, and yan, ito lang yung times 3 months. Yes, there will be extra cost kung wala kang cellphone. Kasi nagamit ka ng camera eh. Or kung wala kang computer. Pero normally, you don't need to buy a camera because you have a cellphone na may camera. And you don't need to buy a microphone if your computer has a microphone. Okay? Normally. Unless you're going to do yung video shooting talaga na mayroong studio style, bibili ka ng ilaw, ganun. Hindi naman lahat ng video kailangan ng studio style. Okay? Yung lesson sa loob na, yung sa akin live, yung webinar ko na 3 months, so gonna be 6 webinars all in all, is live. We're gonna have a live meeting kung naka 20 ang mga mag-join. So can't afford the venue kung less than 20 ang mag-join. Libo eh, yung venue. Tapos, pagdating dito sa video genesis, these are all videos. You're going to learn by watching videos. I can help you by telling you how to get the videos into your iPads and iPhones and Samsungs. Pero you need to access their videos kasi kanila yan. Okay? So, hindi siya live. Though I'm sure meron tong live webinars. Lagi naman eh. May live webinars to kung may questions kayo. They're going to entertain you. Ang catch of course is gonna be Pacific time. So, kung anong oras nilang gawin yon, you might be listening to the live webinars nila madaling araw. Depende kung nasaan ka, obviously. Madaling araw or gabi. Ganon. Hindi akin to. Video genesis is not mine. Ang may-ari nito si Andy at saka si Mike. So, sinusupport ko lang sila kasi sila yung talagang expert sa video making. And they've proven to us that they know how to make it by showing us the videos ng video genesis. So, ang website to go, I forgot, sorry ah, yung sabi sa inyo, kailangan prepare mo to. So, the website to go to get this, then I'm gonna say goodbye na after this ah. Nantuloy, I forgot the website. Saan nga ba pumupunta yan? Hey, dears, ano ba yung website ng Video Genesis? Again, yung link ko. You have to use my link ah, because that's how it works. You have to use my link. Ay, nahanap ko yung link ko. Oh, natulog na yung aking mga VAs. VAs, where's my link? Learn video something? Naalala niyo yung link ko for Video Genesis? Learn video now? Okay, I forgot. Dami ng links, grabe. Wait lang ha. I forgot the very most important link of all. The payment link. Ah, yun. Wanna learn video. That's it. Sorry. So, huwag gagawin nyo na. Ako lang ang pwedeng gumawa nun. Kailangan sa inyo gawin nyo professional on the thing. Ayan. So, that's the website to go to get to join. Okay. jhilar.com/wanna learn video. jhilar.com/wanna learn video. Use that link so I can support you. Okay. That's my affiliate link. jlr.com, wanna learn video. That's it. Okay. So yun lang, I know you learn a lot today. Kahit na i-deny ninyo, marami kayo natutunan kasi minsan lang ako magsabi ng mga sikreto on video making. And this video will be up in YouTube tonight and will be up only hanggang 24th of July. Then I'm gonna take it down because it has secrets. Okay? I'm going to teach you some more secrets on creating video. I will encourage you while you're in the journey. katulad ng encouragement ko sa Authority ROI, which by, however, ang dami na nilang websites. Marami silang websites na na-create. Kahit na disappointed din sila dun sa Authority ROI na product, yung support ng group at saka support na binigay ko sa kanila was more than enough para magawa nila yung dapat nilang gawin, which is the website. So, a lot of the graduates of the previous program I endorsed na hindi naman akin, meron na silang Authority websites, ginagrow na lang nila. And this is the second level, creating video so that people will pay attention to you in YouTube, in Facebook, and all over the internet. So, thank you very much for joining. Consider joining Video Genesis. Go to jhilar.com/wannalearnvideo. And I'll be supporting you for the next 3 months. Okay, very good. Thank you, Teddy. Goodbye.